After the swearing-in, Prime Minister Modi has taken charge for the third time today, and he has prioritized the welfare of farmers by signing his first file authorizing the release of the 17th installment of the PM Kisan Nidhi Yojana. This initiative is set to benefit 9.3 crore farmers, remember, distributing approximately Rs 20,000 crores. Prime Minister Modi underscored his government's unwavering commitment to agricultural prosperity, emphasizing that this decision exemplifies their dedication to the welfare of farmers. He further expressed his determination to continue working tirelessly for the advancement of farmers and the agricultural sector in the future. That's the first decision taken by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. There you have it on your screens, visuals of the Prime Minister as he has resumed office today morning. And the first file that he has signed is the release of the PM Kisan Nidhi Yojana. My colleague Manohar Kesri with us on the broadcast. Manohar, if you can take our viewers through the details. Prime Minister Modi has, of course, resumed office. Visuals of him arriving in South Block have emerged. And right after that, Manohar, we saw Prime Minister in his office signing his first file as he begins his third term.
देखिए, बिल्कुल आपने सही कहा. प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी करीब 11 बजे के आसपास जो है वो पीएमओ दफ्तर यानी साउथ ब्लॉक में पड़ता है, वहाँ पर पहुँचे. यहाँ जब मैं यहाँ पर मौजूद हूँ विजय चौक पर, यहाँ से कुछ ही फासले पे साउथ ब्लॉक है, और प्रधानमंत्री कर्मचारियों से मुलाकात की, उन्हें भी धन्यवाद दिया, और उसके बाद उन्होंने पदभार संभाला. यानी प्रधानमंत्री का जो है सो औपचारिक तौर पर जो है सो कार्यभार संभालने के बाद उन्होंने पहले आधे घंटे की, अगर हम बात करें, एक घंटे नहीं, पहले हाफ एन आवर में उन्होंने पहली साइन किसानों के फायदे के लिए साइन किया है. और उन्होंने किसान निधि सम्मान की जो 17th इंस्टॉलमेंट है, 17वीं किस्त है, वो भी 20,000 करोड़ रुपए की, वो उन्होंने दिया है. प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी ने जब संकल्प पत्र की घोषणा की थी, जब संकल्प पत्र को लॉन्च किया था चुनाव से पहले, तब उन्होंने कहा था कि बीजेपी जो है सो न्याय के लिए काम करेगी. न्याय कहने का मतलब है चार कैटेगरी है, जिनमें से एक किसान आते हैं, और किसानों के फायदे के लिए उन्होंने पहली साइन की है. और हालांकि चुनाव से पहले ही एक किस्त जानी थी, लेकिन MCC लागू हो गया था जिसकी वजह से ये नहीं जा पाया था. लेकिन सबसे पहले उन्होंने किसानों को ध्यान दिया है, इससे ये पता चलता है कि मोदी सरकार जो है मोदी 3.0 किसानों के लिए कितना प्रतिबद्ध है. और इसका असर सीधे तौर पर आने वाले विधानसभा चुनावों में पड़ेगा. अगर हम अगले 6 महीने की बात करें तो कई राज्यों में विधानसभा चुनाव हैं, महाराष्ट्र है, हरियाणा है, दिल्ली है, झारखंड है, तो इसका असर वहां भी देखने को मिलेगा और उन किसानों को भी फायदा पहुंचेगा. जी
right, absolutely, Manohar, big news there, of course. And Manohar, also interestingly, this is the first decision that has been taken by the Narendra Modi government. So we've been seeing, and perhaps the government continues to drop some hints as to what their priorities will be in their third term, because at the swearing in ceremony, Manohar, we saw a mix of guests who are workers and laborers who worked on the flagship schemes of the current government. And there were also, of course, we saw leaders, heads of states of South Asian nations. So our neighborhood first policy was on clear display as far as the swearing-in ceremony is concerned. But today, when the Prime Minister has resumed office, he is also now sending a message out to the farmers of the country that they continue to be a priority for this government.
देखिए, बिल्कुल ये जताता है कि भले ही NDA की सरकार हो, पहले की तरह स्थिति ना हो, लेकिन उन्होंने अपनी मंशा, अपना उनका जो कटिबद्धता है, जिस तरह से उन्होंने संकल्प पत्र में लिया, वो जताता है. और इस 17वीं इंस्टॉलमेंट से 9.3 करोड़ फार्मर्स को फायदा पहुंचेगा, क्योंकि अब आप देखिए खरीफ फसल का सीजन आने वाला है, शुरू भी हो गया है, और ऐसे में किसानों को किन किन चीज़ों की ज़रूरत है. अगर ये पैसा उनके अकाउंट में जाएगा तो उनको इससे काफ़ी ज़्यादा बेनिफिट मिलने वाला है. तो आप समझिए, सिर्फ यही नहीं, शाम 5 बजे कैबिनेट की बैठक बुलाई है, उससे पहले उम्मीद है कि दोपहर तक तमाम जो 71 मिनिस्टर्स ने ओथ लिए हैं उनके पोर्टफोलियो डिसाइड हो जाएंगे, और उसके बाद जब शाम में 5 बजे कैबिनेट की बैठक होगी उसमें एजेंडा 2 हो सकता है। एक, प्रधानमंत्री पहले भी कह चुके हैं 100 डेज के लिए हमने काम शुरू कर दिया है, तो 100 डेज में वो क्या कुछ करने वाले हैं वो तय किया जाएगा। जैसा कि अभी उन्होंने बता दिया कि टेक ओवर लेते ही उन्होंने 20,000 करोड़ रुपये किसानों के खाते में डाल दिए। दूसरी बात, पार्लियामेंट सेशन शुरू होना है और जिसमें फुल बजट को पास कराना है, तो उसे लेकर के भी डेट डिसाइड हो सकता है। जी
राइट, एब्सोल्युटली मनोहर, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग अस ऑन द ब्रॉडकास्ट। वी आल्सो हैव विद अस हिमांशु। बट हिमांशु, बट इंटरेस्टिंग दैट प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदीज फर्स्ट डिसीजन एज ही रिज्यूम्स ऑफिस इज टू रिलीज द पीएम किसान निधि योजना एंड दोज फंड्स टू द फार्मर्स ऑफ इंडिया। व्हाट डू यू मेक ऑफ दिस डिसीजन? Himanshu Bhatt, can you hear me? Okay, we seem to have lost that line with Himanshu Bhatt. But viewers, what we are discussing right now is, of course, Prime Minister Modi signing his first file, which pertains to the release of the PM Kisan Nidhi Yojana. Prime Minister Modi has authorized the release of the 17th installment of the PM Kisan Nidhi, which will benefit 9.3 crore farmers, and it translates to an amount of roughly 20,000 crore rupees. So that decision has been taken on the very first day. Himanshu Bhatt back with us on the broadcast. Mr. Bhatt, if you can hear me, I was just asking your views on the fact that today the Prime Minister, upon resuming office, the first decision he's taken is to release the funds to the farmers. What do you make of this decision?
It is very symbolic, and it means that Modi 3.0 means business for farmers. Now, farmers have been misled to a great extent, and people have been trying in the upper northern parts of the country, you know, to fool them. And they have been misled, basically. By releasing this fund, he has given a very straight signal to the farmers that this government is going to do everything possible for them, for their benefit. Because farmers are really the backbone of Indian economy. And when people mislead them, and I'm using this word again and again, people are misleading them and they go into the agitation. Now, with this government, this might be a coalition government, but it has no compulsions and it means business. And the business is very, very clear, the welfare of our farmers. And that will be done in no uncertain ways, whichever way you want to look at it. You know, this Kishan Kalyan Nidhi Yojana is going to benefit a large amount of farmers across Haryana, Western Uttar Pradesh and such, even Punjab, and they have been agitating on so many things, but they don't seem to realize that, you know, things could be normal if they adopt a tactic of talking on the table and not unnecessarily agitating and blocking entire Delhi and trying to take Delhi to ransom. This is a very clear signal to the farmers that government means business and it means a good business with them, and it gives them a priority. And in a country like India, which is agricultural based initially, and even right now, you know, the welfare of farmers is a supreme priority, and that's what government is going to do. That is the basic message that we are giving it to them.
Absolutely. At the same time, Himanshu, do you feel that somewhere, like you said, because farmers and the issues of farmers did become slightly contentious under the previous government, in fact, under the previous term, I should say. So, therefore, this time around, the Narendra Modi government wants to be extremely careful with the message that they're sending out to the farmers, because the farm laws were also highly twisted, and the government is just making sure this time around.
Yes, their government is really making sure. And, you know, as I told you, again, I'll use that word, you know, misleading farmers by not giving them the correct information. It's something like, you know, I'll give you an example. The Punjab water tables have gone down so much and still they want to continue growing the crops. What they are doing, instead of that, if they go for certain crops which an innovative farming has suggested, they would make more money. But that needs to be understood. The water depleted water tables will have to be brought up. Now, these are far more bigger issues than, you know, actually going out on the street and asking for MSP, you know, for all the crops and this and that and all. These are all opposition propaganda. And to, you know, dislodge this propaganda, certain welfare measures were very much necessary. And proactively doing this work on the 3.0, Modi government has shown that it is committed to farmers always.
Absolutely. Himanshu, but thank you so much for joining us on the broadcast with your views and perspective. So that is, of course, those are visuals of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. They're signing his first file. Sumit Peer with us on the broadcast as well. Sumit, the Prime Minister has taken a decision this morning that as he resumes office, the first file that he will be signing will be the release of the PM Kisan Nidhi Yojana. About 20,000 crore rupees worth of funds have been released as the first decision of the government. And he says that we will continue to prioritize the welfare of the farmers of India, who are the backbone of the nation. What do you make of this decision, Sumit?
Devikaji, good morning. I think it is continuity from Modi 2.0 to Modi 3.0. What some people thought, there will be change of politics, you know, and the coalition, it will be a different Modi, he's going to act differently. No. He's signaling very strongly that all my welfare measures, all my reforms, all my visionary decisions will continue the way they have been continuing. It doesn't matter whether the government is in alliance or it's a full BJP sarkar. Everything will go as per it is going, and it also signals that, you know, that welfare and development of Kisan and the ruler India remains the priority, because that is the first decision which he has taken. It's a very good step. So all the people who had apprehensions, who had doubts, who were casting aspersions, no, it is won't change, things will be different and all. He's signaling its continuity, and it's at a much faster pace. And I hope and I pray that the Modi 3.0 will be much more aggressive than Modi 2.0, because that is what the mood of the nation is. And looking at the things which are happening around us, especially if you look at the AIC attacks last night and all, looking at all those things, I think we people will be expecting more from Modi 3.0. And Modi ji has his own style of working, which will continue as it is. It's a continuity. So that's a very important change. Continuity from 2.0 into 3.0, nation building, nation first, they are the objectives.
Absolutely. At the same time, Sumit, do you feel that the government also wants to be very careful this time around with the messaging to the farmers? Because we have seen in the past two terms with the farm laws being twisted around as well. And of course, major protests of the farmers taking place in states like Punjab. The government really just wants to be careful and wants to perhaps let the farmers know that we are on your side. We're not against you.
I mean, Devikaji, if you go logically, if you go into it, government was never against the farmers. If you look at Modi's tenure, everything has 2.5 times the MSP. Highest procurement, highest production. People talk of rural distress. If there is highest procurement, highest production, where is the rural distress? If we are controlling 40% of the world's food grain, where is the rural distress? Even these all, you know, the Punjab issues and these Haryana issues vis-a-vis farmers mostly were manifested, mostly were political in nature. But the Modi government would be careful in a way that the schemes and the development agenda and the whatever things are on the platter, they should keep on happening, they should continue, they should improve. So this notion of opposition that the government is against farmer and all stands nullified, because there was never anything, there will be never anything. Because farmers are very important part of our economy and society. So how can any government be against farmers? This is all what was the canards that were killed, you know, what were successfully been to some extent being able to be created by the opposition. So what you have to fight is not the intention. Intention is there. What you have to fight is the agendas. Those canards which should be again built as and when they get a first opportunity. They will again build. If you look at the yesterday AIC's attacks, unfortunately, nobody is condemning terrorists in Pakistan. They are trying to say it's a security breach. This is what the security of the state is. You are not talking Pakistan still, you're not still talking terrorists. That is the politics, even when the people get killed, unfortunately, in our country.
Absolutely. So, thank you so much for joining us on the broadcast. We also have Indrashekhar Singh, agricultural expert. Indrashekhar Singh, what do you make of the government's decision, the first decision and the first file to be signed by the Prime Minister in his third term is the release of the PM Kisan Nidhi Yojana funds to the farmers of the nation. What do you make of this decision? And also, Indra, what would be your hopes then from the government as far as the third term is concerned in terms of taking the farmers of India forward?
See, first of all, thank you for having me on your show. It is the most symbolically, the most important step that the Prime Minister could have taken in his third Prime Ministership. Because the Indian agrarian sector is suffering through a very deep crisis. You know, again, the inflation numbers were in, food inflation had risen by 9% even in past months. So when the government comes out and actually says, well, you know, we want to do something for 60% of our country, we want to do 60% of Indians living in the country, which are actually farmers and people allied to the farm sector, I think this is a very positive approach. I think this is a first step, and the government should bring back its original programs of doubling farmers' incomes. It should bring back other programs, flagship programs, you know, should improve on the Fasal Bima Yojana, so that the really, you know, the mistakes that were made in the past 10 years do not get repeated in the third term. And if the farmers stand, if the government stands with the farmers, let me assure you that the farmers will stand with the government. And if we actually think about, you know, the government has had many, many commissions, many senior policy people have been involved. The other step that the government should do is now bring farmers on the policy table. If the Modi government improves on its policy decisions, gets the farmers, gets all stakeholders, I think India can be an unstoppable agrarian force with only little amount of policy initiatives from the government. I once again, you know, commend the government for having the Kisan Nidhi and starting off with that as the first decision. But this is just one arrow doesn't make a summer. So we should have more programs, more empowerment in the agriculture sector. We should ensure that there should be a fair balance where industry and the farmers are fairly treated. Both of them are fairly treated. There should not be a bias for either the farmers or for the industry. And I think that's the path forward moving in agriculture for the government. I think that should be the flagship theme. All the people who are trying to, you know, who actually helped the government make mistakes. You know, there were also many mistakes made in the previous two terms because of lobby groups and other influence groups. I think Modi government should see them, and now it's time to throw them out. It's time to bring in the real stakeholders so that the country can progress and Indian agriculture can be a solid footing in the next 5 years.
Absolutely. Indrashekhar Singh, at the same time, the agricultural industry as a whole and the farming industry as a whole does require then some careful thought and consideration given the sort of global circumstances that we're looking at. We've already, of course, discussed at length what it means in terms of global instability and uncertainty with certain wars erupting in certain regions and how we need to, of course, be extremely food sufficient and efficient, which India has achieved that goal, of course. But going forward, there will also be problems of climate change. There are already heat waves and there are erratic conditions that would require the government to give a very careful thought and consideration and to also invest heavily in upgrading the agricultural and farming systems of India if required, which would then be a two-way street of clear communication, something that we saw amiss as far as the farm laws were concerned.
See, absolutely, you raised a very important point, and I've said this many times on your channel, that till 2017, India is experiencing a climatic transition. What that means is that we do not know, and if we look at data from the past 2 to 3 years, since actually corona lockdowns were on, the climate in India has been changing. The agroclimatic zones, you know, the season sometimes is raining when it's not supposed to rain, it's getting hot when it's supposed to be cold, so all these other things are happening. So we should be very, very careful in trying to understand first that what is this transition and change. The El Nino effect is one of them. The other, you know, the Rimal cyclone, which is happening now. Last year, Biparjoy happened. So all these erratic climatic conditions are causing more problem. And you know what? The technology, we don't have the current technology. All the big talk about AI and all that, it's not working for India. We could not have predicted the weather. Even if we had predicted the weather, we could not let our farmers know about it, because of which India suffered huge economic losses when it comes to wheat harvest and other crops all over the country from Madhya Pradesh to Punjab. In 2 years, there were massive wheat losses because of which we could not export. So India right now, and just coming back to now the main topic which you raised, you know, the international chaos that's happening in the food sector because of the Ukraine-Russia war, dampened harvests in Brazil, in America, soybean harvests were basically dampened. So India is actually at a juncture where we can ride the chaos ladder. Because there's so much chaos in the world, we can ride it if with good policy. If India is actually looking towards agroecological ways of farming, which are actually reducing the burden on the taxpayer also by reduction of fertilizers, reduction of water, having a more biodiverse farming, which is also a program of the government, you know, the Paramparagat Kriti Mission. If the government really galvanizes that, I think there is climate resilience which is inbuilt in a very cost-effective way when you do farming in the biodiverse agroecological way. I think that India needs this approach at least for the next 3 years. Now, the other thing is the crop insurance scheme. That is a very, very important scheme that needs to be expanded, that needs to be covering all these erratic events. And till 2027, the government should have special clauses because the climate is changing. And it's changing beyond any scientific forecast. Even the satellites cannot forecast what's happened to the climate in India. So there needs to be special sections within that scheme so that the farmers are protected. And also biodiverse crops, monoculture should actually be told that farmers should not do monoculture, which is just one single cropping of one crop, which is highly prone to erratic weather, susceptible to all these weather, erratic weather events. There should be multi-cropping, there should be crop rotation, there should be organic growth. I think all these are scientifically proven facts all over the world now. In fact, the Indian agricultural scientists are also coming around right. And saying that So we need low-cost investments which actually work. We do not want top-up heavy investment solutions which have actually failed to bring any relief to the farmers. So there is the government is already on its line. The government is already has some foundational programs. We just need to press the accelerator on them.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.